And yet the truth of the matter is, we resist dying. I'm starting to think as I go by cemeteries, and that's where I'm going to end up. We are quick. I don't like that thought, but I'm starting to think that thought more all the time. We're called to die so we can live, but we fight to live. And my brothers and sisters, when we want to live our own way, our own will, we die. It's like a little child that grabs a puppy and loves it to death. Sometimes we do that. And so we have to really begin to reflect on our lives. And if they really are lives of death, so that others can live. As I was reading this gospel, and the Lord spoke about going out for the lost sheep, I had to kind of chuckle that oftentimes I don't do that much anymore. I let the lost one go because I have 99 lost ones. And I often can't afford to put one more with me. It's a sad thing. But it happens at times. And I also thought about two little boys who went out after one of our lost sheep. One of the old ewes got away, and she ran up the hill, and these two little squirts were about yay big, so they weren't going to do anything with this ewe. And so they got up there, and each one grabbed onto a hind leg, and they drove that poor sheep down the hill. And I said, We fight the very thing that's good for us. I was hoping a couple of years ago that I'd never preach to you people again. I don't know why I was hoping that, but I was. And they asked me to preach again this year, and something that came to my mind when I was asked to preach was I really felt like we needed to reflect on where we're headed in this next year. How many of you have fears about what's coming in this next year? Maybe have fears, why? Because of uncertainty. We don't know what's coming. I'm not afraid. Do you know why? I just have today to live what I am called to live. And what happens tomorrow, I'll deal with tomorrow. My brothers and sisters, don't be afraid. St. John tells us that perfect love casts out all fear. When I first reflected on it, I thought, when I love perfectly, I won't be afraid anymore. And there's some truth to that. But you know what takes away the fears of my little boys and girls and our little children? Is that they know they're loved. And my brothers and sisters, we are loved by our Father. We would not be here today if our Father didn't love us. He is gracious and merciful and kind. And he has been so gracious and merciful with us that he has brought us to this day and to this time. And my brothers and sisters, those of us who are alive today are at the most critical juncture in the history of the Society of Our Lady of the Most Holy Trinity since the foundation. It's that important. Thanks be to God. Why did he choose us? I know. I know. But we are the ones that the Lord has put in this place, this time. And we have to overcome all of our fears, because fear paralyzes us. And we have to recognize that we're all working for the same goal. And the goal isn't really pontifical approval. The goal is to be who we're called to be. But if we don't get pontifical approval, we won't be. There's no two choices, my brothers and sisters. There is one choice: to be approved by Rome as a pontifical, as two pontifical societies of apostolic life, with the laity aggregated to the priests, or to die. And in that process, we're going to have to die to our own wills, and our own desires, and our own ways of seeing things. And we're going to have to ask the church to help us to see clearly. Father Brown read a beautiful thing from Campbell. I can't believe I'm saying that. It's beautiful. It's from Campbell. But you know what it was about? It was about patrimony. And when he read that, I was like, that's it. What's our patrimony? And how do we know what it is? The church tells us. It's amazing how the church directs and guides us and leads us all along the path. In Canon 578, it says, all must observe faith in the mind and designs of the founders regarding the nature, purpose, spirit, and character of an institute. Get this. Which have been sanctioned by competent ecclesiastical authority. Do you know what pontifical approval is? It's about finding out what our patrimony is and what's to be preserved for the future. And in sound traditions, all of which constitute the patrimony of the same institute. And so it's important for us to share who we are as best we can and have the church say yay or nay. What happens if the church says nay? Scary, isn't it? You know what I would say? Fiat mihis unum vero tuo. Be it done to me according to your word. Because if our Father taught us anything, he taught us obedience. Obedience to the competent authority of the church. Got a little squirrely until old age, but he would always come back to that, wouldn't he? To be obedient. And my brothers and sisters, that's the rub. That's what's difficult, is to be obedient. And we have to live this gift that we've been given from Father Flanagan, that's manifested through our constitutions, through our directories, through all of those things. But we have to capture the essence, the heart of it. Because not everything is perfect. We have not done everything exactly right all the way along. And all you have to do is look at a couple of lawsuits and that becomes very clear. We have to correct the things that are wrong and help the things that are correct and right flourish and grow. And this is a time of self-reflection in our community. That we look at ourselves, and we don't look at each other, but we look at ourselves and say, what am I doing to make this I want to just sum up our charism in one word. Because we were asked to do that. And there's a whole boatload of words we came up with. Beautiful words. Fan, grace, friendship, that's two words. I mean, this county is a little bit of a fast now, I know they did not. But as I reflected upon it, and I'm not tooting my own horn, I don't think this is necessarily the best one, but for my purposes today, it serves a purpose. And that one word is relationship. Because if we look at our charism statement, deep disciples of Jesus to marry, living in marriage, entering the communion, what is that about? Relationship, the Trinity. As disciples of Jesus to marry. And when we look at serving on ecclesial family teams, that's about our relationship amongst ourselves. So we have the relationship with the Trinity, we have the relationship amongst ourselves in areas of need. How we relate to the world. Why do I want to emphasize relationship? Is because I think that's where our fear is. I think our fear is that we won't live the charism part that's the ecclesial family. I think everybody's gung-ho from the marrying Trinitarian community. And I think everyone's gung-ho about serving in the deepest apostolic, there is a deepest apostolic meaning. And really everyone is gung-ho about ecclesial family things, but we've got a whole variety of ideas about those teams. And that's what's scary. Don't be afraid. Amongst all of us as well. but recognizing that the middle road is in between. Because our relationships can be too far apart, and they can be too close. I have certain relationships that can be too close if I'm not careful. And we have to recognize that. We have to recognize our relationships amongst each other in our community are the most difficult for us. Because what did Father Flanagan speak about? Grace friendships. I always chuckle when people identify their grace friendships because they're such good friends. I designate those friendships as grace friendships with the people I just don't like. And sure as hell don't like me. Because it takes grace to be friends. And that's what's called for all of us. And my brothers and sisters, if we're not careful and we don't work to strive in our grace friendship with each other, we look for friendship without. And that's happened. And so we have to recognize that oftentimes the grace friendship is the one that's the most difficult. The one that's the easiest is probably an active friendship. Although grace might be building with that nature of that friendship. But we have to work that out. And we have to recognize where our tendency is. My tendency is to get further apart. It's just who I am. But it's not who I'm called to be. And so I recognize in myself that I have to strive to relate more with my priests, with the sisters, with the lays. And so recognize your tendency. Recognize your weakness. And strive to overcome that. My brothers and sisters, Father Flanagan gave us a beautiful gift. I believe that God gave us a beautiful gift through Father Flanagan. We're at a time that's not a time to be afraid. It's a time to charge. It's a time to strive forward. And to say, we have something good that has been given to us that we want to present to the church, to ask the church's blessing, and to be grateful for those who have slaved day in and day out to put those things together. Because it's not an easy job. And just try to live it out. Because we have a serious responsibility to that. And we can't let ourselves be divided. You see, it's all coming back to relationship, isn't it? The evil one will get amongst us and try to